Hey JV, what's happening?
Yo, Kev. So, I'm just finishing a few little emails. It's January, it's 10 to 7, it's cold, and what I'm going to do is, I'm going to have a little walk around, update you all on what's going on. So, get your jacket on, and let's go. GTR Kev, you know it. I'm going for a little bit more power. 900 just isn't enough when I'm surrounded by all these fast cars. So if I'm lucky, Chris might have a look at these injectors tomorrow, swap them for some bigger ones, and I'm gonna get Romain just to turn a little bit of the boost up. Who would like to see that? If you do, put it in the comments. So I'm here with Chris, Jody Chris Thompson, who's in charge of the dyno really. So this is John's JM 900 horsepower GTR
RS7.
In sync, actually, me and him sync a lot.
It's pretty bad.
Like. Anyway, back to this because I don't want to waste his time. Thanks, precious.
Yeah.
So we've done a few mods, I'm not going to go into details. Check out on our Instagram what we've done. But Chris is about to tune this now, so we're going to leave him alone and John's 900 horsepower RS7.
Yeah.
So, my McLaren, you've seen the video Callum done. Windows, they're going to be ready at the end of the month. They're going to be carbon. And just for those who know, McLaren didn't get back to us. They just kind of just fobbed me off. So, McLaren, shame on you. Anyway, this McLaren is Chris's. He's getting some aftermarket radiators fitted. What else? We're fixing oil leak from his dry sump system that comes from the factory. It's a combination of a 12C as well. So, if you've got a 12C and you have these kind of issues, hit me up and we'll sort it out for you. So Darren's GTR, he's obviously works offshore and obviously we look after his car. At the minute it's getting a Mortec dash install, so it's still here doing some electronic upgrades. This is the GM King of Race Wars, that's what this is. So this is Hammett's twin turbo Lemborghini. We put new turbos on just before Christmas, had it tuned a couple of weeks ago, early new year, after the new year. This made nearly 1700 horsepower on a stock engine and a stock box. So obviously it's pushing boundaries, but it's a fast car. Bear in mind, this car did 100 to 200 km in 2.6 seconds. So we're gonna get Jolie Thompson out and see if he can beat that.
Let's go.
This is another Lamborghini, belongs to Jay from the Cannon Run. We did a VF supercharger kit. 2017 or 2018. It's got a Cybex ECU. It's come for a bit of a tune up and latest updates because obviously the software was out a long time ago. So this is Jay's Hurricane, one of many cars he's got. Jay, someone's cracked your bumper. Okay, on the ramps we have George's GM1000 car that was built just before Christmas. He still hasn't collected it. George, your baby is here and it's ready for you. Actually, while I'm here as well, George has now got his own YouTube channel, so please go and subscribe it. Kevin will put
the link down below.
And then underneath here is DJ Arius's GTR, which is a GM900. Again, that's all ready. It's been ready since December, but again, he hasn't collected. All these customers aren't collecting their cars. Right, next one. This car. Jan's been working a lot on this car. This has got a HPS engine. I mean, full restoration. I don't know if you can zoom a little bit under here, Kevin, see? I mean, it's just unbelievable stuff. Unbelievable. Okay. So, this is the Landlord's Mercedes 5.5. Common issue with these cars, the crankshaft brakes on them. So, Scott is literally fitting a new engine. Big job. He's been doing a good job on this as well. So, hopefully by the end of the week, this is up and running. Okay, let me show you some more stuff. We'll be right back. sure, it's GTR. It's running about 1100 horsepower, just a little bit more than that, I think, now on ethanol. He broke his clutch before Christmas in a prop shaft, so this is getting now a custom prop shaft and a 22 plate custom clutch from Sheps. So let's go out and see some more stuff. My GTR, Kyle's fixed the issue with the electronics on it, so it now runs, there's no ignition getting stuck in, so this car's ready to rock and roll for the season. The big Russian GTR, Kyle's busy doing the gearbox, there was an issue with the gearbox as well. He's stripping that down, the engine's ready to go in now, so our focus this month and the next month is to get this bad boy ready for the customer. So Kimmy's SVJ, this car's got the full Gintani F1 package, titanium exhaust, titanium valves, titanium everything. This car's gonna sound unbelievable. So it's also getting the decals took off. ECU's been sent off to Gintani as part of the package. So we're waiting for that to come back, and we're also waiting for the parts for Gintani. So yeah, Kyle's doing this at the minute as well, at his other project. So yeah, looking forward to that. And then on the gearbox section, if you come over here, Kyle's busy stripping the Russian gearbox. There's a couple of issues with that, so he's going through the whole lot. And then we've got another Dodson box. We are Dodson dealers. If you need any Dodson parts, anything related to GTRs, we're the guys to help you. So at the minute, Kyle's going through another Dodson box as well for somebody else, a trader. I'm not gonna touch his stuff here because it's all nice and neat, but this is where the magic for the gearbox is happening. So we've got an Ismo GTR, again this came for a service, it's ready to be collected, we're just waiting for the owner to collect. Project Tango V2. Bad. I can't get out of bed, no drugs make me bad. I can't get out of bed, yeah drugs are bad. I can't get out of bed, no drugs make me bad. I can't get out of bed, yeah drugs are bad. Right, this car should be getting fired up tomorrow, ready to run in. Remains here tomorrow. This is gonna be up and running. This is version 2. So a lot of people asking, what happened to his original V1? Well, V1 engine went to Jasper's Pink GTR, which is next door. I don't know if you've seen it or the, yeah, it's outside at the minute because obviously the ramps are out. That car has got Hammett's old engine. So that's gonna be interesting to see what that does, because obviously hasn't quite got the parts what Hammett has, but the engine's there, the turbo kit's there, but he hasn't got the drive shafts and such, so we're gonna push it as hard as Jasper wants us to push the car. I would say we probably should see 1800 horsepower, but if he wants to go on the strip, Jasper's gonna have to upgrade the shafts. I don't know if you can see here, on a GTR, basically you've got DSS drive shafts you need to upgrade. Jasper's car doesn't have that, so we've gotta be very careful with Jasper's car, but basically he has got Hammett's old part of his car, which Hammett did 2000 horsepower. This one we're aiming for about 2200, 2300, okay? But with some 68 mil turbos. This is the quickest and fastest customer R35 GTR in the UK. This is belongs to Parth, Stealth GTR. So I don't know if you follow me stories, but you seen that nice shiny billet nose cone? This is for Parth. He actually broke the nose cone late October when we went drag racing, so we're just going to fit that and the car's ready to go again. Obviously it's a monster car. You were also going to be fitting a carbon roof as well. Okay, it's not on, but yeah. So we've got Ross's Time Attack Subaru Impreza, what Dean's been working on. Dean's obviously working on this and also Project Tango V2. This is going to get started maybe a week after this one. No, in fact, we've got Paul Cameron's Audi TTRS is getting finished off, and then this is next, okay? Lambo, my Hurricane, if you come around the back here, Kevin. Twin turbo kit, 2000 horsepower. We're going to start tuning on pump finally tomorrow. We've been doing a chiller kit install to keep temperatures down because there's so far a lot from that. So yeah, I'll keep this sweet and simple. I'll not go on about my car because there's going to be a big feature on my car soon. Let's go. I'm in the engine room. Okay, Jimmy's on holiday, so I'll just explain what's going on. We've got Chrysler Thompson from JM. This is his RB26 that we're building, okay? This is Rocky's old engine from the Joker, which is gonna go on Warren's car, which is on the ramp. I don't know if you've seen that, but obviously, anyway, that's the car. We didn't really go into detail on Warren's car at the minute, because that, again, is gonna be a feature for another day. Some bits here, obviously I love to have trolleys when we strip cars down. This, I believe, I don't know whose engine this is. I think this is Paul Squires' engine. And yeah, he's doing some heads. But again, I'm gonna leave this because Jimmy's on holiday and I don't like people to come in here. Okay, lights off. Is that sexy nose cone made out of billet for Parv's GTR. That's what he broke in the last year. Okay. But anyway, just guys, let me know if you enjoyed the video. It took about 10 minutes. Leave in the comments. If you want this kind of weekly content where I just update on customers' cars, where we're at, I'm happy to do it as long as you like it. But if you do like it, get your friends to subscribe, like the channel. But any feedback, me and Kevin are just having a little go to see if this is something you'd like to see. We're not professional editors. We're not like software geeks, but we're just trying our best to give you a bit of content. If you like this and you're happy with this, I will continue to do it. Okay, guys, see you later.